Adaptation to climate change is becoming more and more prominent nationally, regionally, and globally. Colleagues, we represent part of the group of small islands and coastal low-lying states that contribute the least to climate change, but are among the most vulnerable with regard to the negative impacts of climate change.
I think the National Adaptation Planning process is a very significant one because it's timely right now, as we see that the Paris Agreement is being ratified and moving into action. It offers a concrete and specific opportunity for vulnerable countries to think about what they can do across a variety of sectors and to proactively plan to take advantage of those opportunities.
The process to develop the NAP allows us to set in a robust manner medium and long-term goals for climate change adaptation on island.
We need to understand what our objectives are, our visions, and to develop our plans to ensure that we are able to take full advantage of the international support that is available to us.
Guerrera is an active participant in the NAP Global Network. It allows sharing of experiences with other countries in the network, so there are countries like the Philippines, Brazil, Kenya. So we have countries from other regions, countries with different circumstances that we can learn from their experience.
That networking opportunity has helped us to learn a tremendous amount from what has worked in other countries, as well as to share with them what has worked in Grenada.
So the NAP Global Network is a global forum that allows bilateral donors and developing countries to come together to work together on national adaptation planning processes.
When we established the network, we recognized that the U.S. was supporting NAPs, that most countries were beginning to engage in them, and so we thought that if we came together, we could share lessons on what was working and what was not working. And it's been an honor to work with the German government, in particular with GIZ, both here in Grenada, but also globally on the NAP Global Network.
Because the NAP process is involved in lots of stakeholders, we think that the single donors or the single development partner cannot address to all. We have to get together as the donors or the development partners to do some work together to be more effective.
A lot of people are doing this for the first time, but I think there is great value in having countries working together on how this process is going to continue to unfold in the years ahead. And what we've tried to do through the NAP Global Network is allow that learning to be sustained.
We can focus on opportunities and say, yes, we can do this in our island. This is feasible, it's realistic, it's doable, and we have to do it right now.